So this time, what I want to show you is how to calculate the amount of spoil we're going to excavate and the amount of concrete we're going to have to put back into our strip footing for our building. So here's our view of our strip footing with our dwarf wall. The reason I'm going to show you the dwarf wall is when we first get our plans, all our dimensions are taken to the outside of the building, not necessarily outside of the footing. So the first thing we need to do is actually work out what length our footing is. Okay, so what we need to do is add a certain amount to each end of our dimension. Well, find the right spot. Okay, the way we work that out is our footing in this case is 350 mil wide. Our dwarf wall is 230 mil wide. So 350 minus 230 gives us 110, 120, and half of that, because this is positioned central on the footing, so half of 120 is 60. So it's we're going to have 60 mil here. Which means we're also going to have 60 mil here. So we have to go all the way around our footing and add 60 mil to each end or 120 mil to our to each dimension. All right, so that's what we do there. And then we get our new dimensions for our footing. Then what we can do, just while we're at it, our footing's 350 wide, we've already discussed that, and it's also 500 mil deep, and we'll need that a little bit later on. So now we can start to work on the calculations. First thing we need to do is to break the footing up into individual lengths, and we don't want to repeat the corners or duplicate the corners. So for each length, we're going to cut off one of the corners. As you can see there, we've just done that, just drawn a line across there to cut off each corner. And we can label them so we know which one's which. Generally, we start at the top and work our way around clockwise for labeling. And then we can start to work it out. So our formula for volume is length times width times depth. So the first thing we need to know is the length of the footing. So for side A, it's going to be our overall dimension minus the width of the footing. That will give us the actual length of side A, which happens to be 4 meters and 640. And we work our way around doing that for all sides. So side B, we're going to minus 350. And when we get to side C, we'll notice that our dimension line actually lines up with our marks, so there's no need to deduct anything for side C. So no deduction. And the way we worked this length out was our overall length up here, which is 4990, 4 meters 990, minus 2 meters 490 gives us 2.5 or 2.5 meters. Side D happens to be the same, a little bit different. If you line up this dimension here, it actually looks like we've got to add the width of our footing, but if you line this one up, you've actually got to then take it off again. So by adding and taking off, we're not changing anything, so it stays the same as well. Once again, this dimension was determined by taking the 2.490 away from the 4.990 there to get 2.5 again. Keep going around. Side E and side F, and we've now done all our sides, so we can add that up and get a total length of our footing, which is 18.560. We then times the length by the width and the depth to get the total cubic meters. So 18.560 times 0.35 for our 350 width and 0.5 for our 500mm deep, half a meter, gives us 3.28 cubic meters of concrete. Now, we have to allow a little bit of waste on top of that because, you know, ultimately there's going to be stuff left in the truck. There's going to be, you know, maybe you'll spill a barrow. Yeah, you're always going to need a little bit more than the actual exact amount. So, going to allow 10% waste. And the way I commonly do that is just by timesing the original cubic meters by 1.10, which will add 10% to the original figure. So it gives us 3.573 cubic meters of concrete to order. Now, concrete's only available in increments of 0.2. So we have to round that up to the next increment of 0.2, which is 3.6. So we're going to order 3.6 cubic meters of concrete for this job. Now, before we can actually pour the concrete, we would have had to excavate for these footings. And now there might be the situation where you actually have to remove the dirt that you've excavated, which is referred to as spoil, and truck the spoil away off your site. So you might have to actually work out how much spoil you're going to have when you finish digging the footings. Now, generally the footings are deeper in the ground, or the top of the concrete doesn't sit flush at the top of the ground. Generally it's in the ground a little bit, possibly a one course of brickwork, which is 86mm, or it could be 100mm in the ground. In this case, I've nominated that the footing is 100mm below the surface of the ground. So to work out the excavation or the spoil, the first step's the same. We still need to know the length of the footing. The second step is essentially the same, except this time, instead of using 500 for the depth, we're now going to use 600 because we've added this the extra 100mm. So it actually works out that we need 3.898 cubic meters of soil is actually going to come out of that excavation. Now, interesting thing with spoil is when it comes out of the ground, it actually occupies more area or more volume out of the ground than it did in the ground, because by excavating it and digging it up, we've added air into the stockpile. So we have to add what they call a bulking factor, because if we ordered enough trucks to carry 3.898 cubic meters of spoil, we will actually have spoil left on the site. So in this case, I've indicated we need 20% bulking. So we times that by 1.20 to add 20% to it, and it gives us 4.678 cubic meters of spoil to be carted away. So you'd need to hire a truck that's big enough, or several trucks, to cart that away. So that's it. That's how we calculate the volume of the spoil and the concrete for a strip footing.